Hi! Welcome! This is a video about my journey. This is my friend James. And this is me, Kenneth. In the next 3 days, we are about to do a grueling hike to the Philippines' highest mountain, Mount Apo. To get to Mount Apo, we had to take a flight from Manila to Davao. The ride took an hour and a half. The next day, we arrived safely in Davao. We were picked up by a van from the airport in Davao City and transported to Kapatagan Digos City, Davao del Sur. We had breakfast in Kapatagan. We also bought packed lunch that we will eat later on the trail. Anyone who wishes to go to the rest room can do so here. And then, we are on our way to the trailhead. From the back of this small truck, we can already see our goal destination, the peak of Mount Apo. And we have arrived to our jump-off point, Hedker de Sanderplan. Let's begin our trek. The trails to Mount Apo were closed for 3 months, from June to August, on its annual off-season. This closure was for the rest and rehabilitation of its natural habitat, allowing wildlife to breed and reproduce. The trails reopened on September 1, 2022. Here is our first stop, the neighborhood of Sitio, Culon. Support the locals by hiring a porter. Having a porter carry your bag makes the hike more manageable. There are several trails to Mount Apo: Kidepawan, Kapatagan, Bansalan, and others. Today we are hiking through Santa Cruz Trail, also known as Sibulan Trail. Along the trail, we can see one of the livelihood of the locals, farming vegetables like cabbage. The horses help farmers carry their produce. Trekking the farmlands was fairly easy since the terrain is flat and it has a low elevation gain. Over the distance, that's our second stop, Sitio Tumpis, the last neighborhood on the trail. Santa Cruz Circuit Trail will take us 3 days and two nights. Today's date is January 13, 2023. We'll be back at jump-off point by January 15th. We are now leaving the farmlands, going into the subtropical forest, where the terrain is more steep and slippery. Be careful not to bury your feet under the mud. No one knows how deep it goes. Poking the mud with your trekking pole first before stepping with your feet will help. Watch your head along the trail. Don't bump into a fallen tree log. On a steep climb, grab onto something to help lift yourself up. Also watch your step and ensure your footing is on a sturdy surface and it is not slippery. It is okay to take small breaks from time to time to hydrate and regain energy. Snack on some trail food such as chocolate bars, energy bars, nuts, and gelatin. This white ribbon marks the trail. Seeing one ensures you are on the right path. We have finally arrived to our campsite. We will be spending our first night here. We are at Tinikaran Campsite 1. 5.4 kilometers to Mount Apo Summit. Tinikaran are the trees surrounding the camp. It is a tree that lives only on altitude not below 1,700 meters above sea level. In this campsite, there is a natural water source. Water which is good for drinking and cooking. I am about to refill my water bottle. Later in the afternoon, as I was about to take a nap, it started raining. Then, it is time for dinner. The rain goes on. For tonight, we had chicken tinola and buffalo wings. Thanks to our guides who prepared our meal for us.
Thank you, sir.
Meals are included in the 6,000 peso tour package, along with other inclusions such as transportation from Davao to jump off point vice versa, accredited tour guide, permits, certificate and camping fee. And that's our adventure so far for day one. Fingers crossed, the rain stops tomorrow. Day two. I woke up early in the morning. At Tinikaran campsite, not only that there is a water source. There's also a comfort room available for hikers to use. Of course, it is expected for people to clean after themselves and take their trash with them. Not leaving any trash anywhere on the trail. Last night, it was right around 20 degrees Celsius, a little bit chilly. The rain continued until morning and water was getting under our tent. It made me feel wet. Let's have our morning coffee. Headlamps and flashlights are handy for providing a source of light when hiking before sunrise and after sunset. Make sure to include them in your gear. Around this area of the mountain, the mobile signal is low to non-existent. And the sun finally caught up to us. The trail after Tinikaran Campsite 1 is muddy and steep. It is especially harder to traverse during early morning when there's little to no light. After passing Tinikaran Campsite 2, we now have arrived to the boulder face, which is around 4 kilometers to summit. Santa Cruz Trail offers such a diverse ecosystem to the hikers. As we have seen, we walked through the farmlands, hiked through the rainforest, and now we are faced with the big boulders. Behind us towards the horizon, we can also see the Davao Gulf and past that, the Philippine Sea. Mount Apo is located near the southeast coastline of Mindanao, Philippines. Every step of the hike, we are rewarded with beautiful sceneries. Around the yellow rock at the distance, where the smoke is coming out of, is a sulfur vent. Smoke can also be seen coming out of holes along the trail. Wearing face mask is recommended during this part of the trail to prevent the inhalation of naturally occurring sulfur. While touching the rocks, I can certainly feel the warmth coming from the internal energy of Mount Apo. The presence of these volcanic rocks proves that Mount Apo is a stratovolcano. There's no record of its last eruption. It is now dormant, or in other words, a sleeping volcano. Even though it has not erupted in a long time, there's still danger of earthquake and landslide present. Be on the lookout for any falling boulders. And to our surprise, at Gabrok Emergency Camp, a troop of monkeys suddenly appeared. Mount Apo is a center of endemism, for serving as a habitat for hundreds of plant and animal species like the Philippine eagle and other critically endangered species. I was lucky enough to take pictures of the monkeys.
Yes, nakuha na ko. Sakto.
Galit na siya?
The monkeys are gathering their food. They are picking these wild blueberries. When I tried it, it has a little sour taste. The dark purple are the ripe ones. And at White Sand Emergency Camp, it started raining again. I had fried fish with rice for my lunch. The rain started pouring even harder. The rain caused us a setback on our itinerary. We are unable to go to the peak today. The heavy rain didn't stop for hours. I will be pitching our tent here. For the rest of the day, we will stay here at White Sand E-Camp. Hike again and go for peak tomorrow morning. Nothing compares to sipping your coffee while admiring this view with the sea of clouds.
Kita siya, ma.
Ano ba sila?
Last night, it was 10 degrees Celsius. There's light rain and it's windy. I can feel the coldness on my back from the ground beneath. I have to reposition myself several times while sleeping. I didn't get enough rest, but we will still continue on, hiking on our last day. This is the most steep slope of the trail. An 87 degree ridge. And once we climb that hard part, Digos Peak is within our reach. The sun rose above the horizon, and we are at one of the peaks of Mount Apo. This is the view from Digos Peak. After the two rainy days, we are finally blessed with a clearing at the peak on our last day. All the hardships paid off. Below is the crater lake. Over there is Mount Tolomo. Mount Apo is the highest mountain in the Philippines, standing mighty at 2,954 meters above sea level. It is an ASEAN Heritage Park. And we head on our way to the Mother Peak. located between the border of North Cotabato and Davao del Sur. We've made it. This is a proud moment I am glad to share with y'all. What a magnificent view. We continue on to Kidepawan Peak. As you can see, there's tall grass here. Protect your arms from scratches by wearing a long sleeve clothing.
Thank you. Tas kaliwa, ay hindi, diretso. Thank you.
Instead of doing a circuit trail, we are doing a back trail instead. Due to the unforeseen circumstances, the first 2 days, we're behind on our schedule and won't be able to go to Lake Venado, Century Tree Traverse. We kept our hiking gear on White Sand E-Camp and we will head back there later. I am wearing my sandals because I am drying my shoes at the moment. That's the geothermal plant beside Mount Apo. Here we are. The third and last summit we'll visit today. Kidepawan Peak. Heading back to White Sand, we took a detour to get some water on a nearby water spring. We had lunch at White Sand and started hiking downhill on the back trail. That's almost the end of our adventure. We have conquered Mount Apo, the grandfather of Philippine mountains. Hopefully we get back to jump off point safely. I hope you got something out of this video, be it knowledge or inspiration. Thanks for watching.